Good morning everyone. Today we are going to start a chapter in which we will study the problems of deficit demand and excess demand. So in this we will study the inflationary gap, deflationary gap, measures to correct excess demand and deficient demand. That means we study the monetary measures and fiscal measures. So let's start first with inflationary gap. Like we know that the equilibrium level of employment and national income, equilibrium level of income and employment, we can say that how we can determine is when AD and AS are equal. Aggregate demand is equal to aggregate supply, or saving is equal to investment, what we have studied. So here inflationary gap, what is inflationary gap, what is excess demand? When our demand is greater than aggregate supply at full employment level. Full employment means when, suppose this is our resources and all the resources are completely utilized. Not even a single resource has been unutilized. All the resources are completely utilized, but still demand is more and the supply cannot be increased. When aggregate demand is more than AS at full employment level and leads to the problem of excess demand. That means goods are less. These are shown goods in the figure, in the PPT. That means these goods are made by employing the complete resources, full employment, right? And buyers are more. Now to control the demand, we have to raise the prices because we cannot increase the supply here. What is deficient demand? The opposite of it, when demand is less than aggregate supply. Demand is less than aggregate supply, although supply has been done by employing all the resources, complete resources. So here we are left with the accumulation of stock. Stock हमारे पास बचा रह जाएगा. अब हम क्या करेंगे? We'll reduce the production, we'll reduce the employment, income will reduce, and we have to reduce the prices as well to increase the demand. This leads to the problem of deficient demand or deflationary gap. Problem of excess demand, when aggregate demand is more than aggregate supply. Now let us explain this with a diagram. On y-axis we have taken aggregate demand, or you can say aggregate supply also along with it. National income has been taken on x-axis. Aggregate demand always starts from the positive y. Aggregate supply and income curve are same. Aggregate supply starts from origin and it makes a 45 degree angle. Aggregate supply is the addition of consumption and savings. This point, the green line which you can see, that this point is the equilibrium point. We can say that it is point E. Point E shows at full employment equilibrium, AD is equals to AS. This is the equilibrium, full employment equilibrium. OM is the equilibrium level of national income. This OM, itana hamari jo hai national income full employment pe hai. Now, ab hum baat karte hain hamari problem ki excess demand. That means when aggregate demand is greater than aggregate supply at full employment level. Now, which is actual demand? This one was the required demand. Ye jo thi hamari required demand thi, planned. But actual one is this. एक्चुअल अगर देखा जाए 82 तो वो इतनी हो गई, तो ये हमारे इक्विलिब्रियम से तो ज़्यादा हो गई. दिस गैप, ये जो गैप आ रहा है हमारी एग्रीगेट सप्लाई से एग्रीगेट डिमांड के बीच में जो गैप आ रहा है, यू कैन सी दैट दिस गैप इज नोन एज इन्फ्लेशनरी गैप और एक्सेस डिमांड. यू कैन सी दैट ई जी इज द एक्सेस गैप, इन्फ्लेशनरी गैप, राइट? नाउ दिस इज़ कॉल्ड द डिमांड पुल इन्फ्लेशन. मतलब डिमांड ज़्यादा थी, डिमांड की वजह से हमारा इन्फ्लेशन बढ़ा, हमारे प्राइसेस हमको राइज करने पड़े. अब इसके कॉजेज़ क्या हैं, क्यों ये आता है इन्फ्लेशनरी गैप? यू जस्ट थिंक अबाउट वॉट आर द कम्पोनेंट्स ऑफ एग्रीगेट डिमांड. कम्पोनेंट्स ऑफ एग्रीगेट डिमांड आर सी प्लस आई प्लस जी प्लस एक्स माइनस एम. That means household sector, producer sector, government sector and rest of the world. When the expenditure of all these four sectors increases, then aggregate demand increases. That means rise in consumption expenditure, rise in government expenditure, increase in exports, more supply, rise in private investment demand. Producer ka ho gaya, ye rest of the world ka ho gaya. साथ में ये हमारा, क्योंकि इंक्रीज इन एक्सपोर्ट्स है, साथ में आप मनी मोर मनी सप्लाईज के साथ लगा सकते हो, ये गवर्नमेंट का हो गया, और ये राइज इन कंजम्पशन हमारा हाउस होल्ड सेक्टर का हो गया. तो ये जो हमारे फोर सेक्टर्स हैं, when the demand or expenditure, you can say that, of all these four sectors increases, at that point aggregate demand increases, and at that point aggregate demand is more than aggregate supply. This is the cause of excess demand, right? And what are the effects of excess demand or inflationary gap? Due to inflationary gap, price kya hoga? When aggregate demand is greater than aggregate supply, what will happen? Definitely prices has to be increased, right? Badhayenge tabhi hum demand ko control kar payenge. What will be the effect on output? Because we have made complete use of all the resources, full employment, output cannot be increased. Kaise badhayenge output? Kuch bacha hi nahi hamare paas output badhane ke liye, right? Employment also cannot be increased, because here we are talking about the full employment level. So there is no change in the output, no change on employment, but prices will increase. And profit pe kya effect padega? Obviously firms will enjoy abnormal profits, because the prices are raising and they don't have to increase the production more. Consumers pe kya effect padega? Consumers are the losers, because prices are increasing. Jahan wo 1 rupaye ki 10 cheeze khareed sakte the, wahan 1 rupaye ki 5 cheeze khareedenge, kyunki wahi cheeze mehangi ho gayi. To real income jo hai unki kam ho jayegi. And on economy, definitely it leads to boom conditions, because everything will be high, prices will be high. और जब लोगों के prices high होंगे, definitely income भी लोगों की increase होगी. I'm not talking here about the real income, but in normal income, when the people are employed, they'll also get the income. लेकिन ये चीज़ें कभी भी ना एकदम से नहीं होती, एक के बाद एक step के बाद होती. जैसे prices बढ़े, अब जो भी employees होंगे, they will ask to increase their salaries, उनकी income बढ़ जाएगी, मनी सप्लाई बढ़ जाएगी, तो इट हैपन्स, राइट? उनकी सेविंग्स भी बढ़ जाएंगी. सो दिस लीड्स टू दी बूम कंडीशंस. आई होप दिस वन इज़ क्लियर टू यू. नाउ प्रॉब्लम ऑफ डेफिशिएंट डिमांड आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग इन माय नेक्स्ट वीडियो. टिल हियर प्लीज़ गो थ्रू दिस टॉपिक. इफ़ यू आर फेसिंग एनी प्रॉब्लम, यू कैन आस्क मी एनी टाइम. थैंक यू. गॉड ब्लेस यू ऑल.